भगवत गीता बाइट साइज लर्निंग एपिसोड 21 अर्जुन विषाद योगा श्लोक 13 14 एंड 15 क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ वॉर म्यूजिक ततः शंखाश्च भैर्यश्च पणवानक गोमुखाः सहसैवाभ्य हन्यन्त सशब्दस्तुमुलो भवत् द मीनिंग ऑफ द श्लोक इज Immediately thereafter, several conches, bugles, trumpets, kettle drums, and cow horns blared forth simultaneously, growing into a tumultuous sound. I would like to share a few interesting facts about wars during ancient times. Musical instruments played an especially important role during the times of war. Is it not difficult to imagine a huge open field where lakhs of warriors congregated with a clear intention to participate in a life-sacrificing activity? Commanders of large armies, they had to pass messages to thousands of soldiers lined up one behind the other. They used large drums, trumpets, bugles, conches, and cow horns to give them directions to follow. The commencement of the war was always announced by playing all the musical instruments together. The war music was definitely useful to raise the spirits of soldiers and keep them moving forward with utmost courage. This verse brings us closer to the war and informs us that Bhishma is eager to announce the commencement of the war. The verse paints a picture of the battlefield and the huge armies marching forward to combat with each other. Tata shvetai haryai yukte mahatisyandane stetau madava pandavas chaiva divyau shankhau pradadmatuhu. The meaning of the shloka is, then seated on a magnificent chariot, harnessed to white horses, Shri Krishna and Arjuna loudly blew their divine conches. This verse introduces us to the key characters of Bhagavad Gita, Shri Krishna and Arjuna. The name Madhava means master of transcendental knowledge. The majestic chariot was gifted by Agni, and the magnificent horses were gifted by King Chitraratha. Shri Krishna and Arjuna blew their divine conches in response to the challenge posed by Bhishma by blowing his conch. Panchajanyam Rishikesho Devadattam Dhananjayah Paundram Dadmau Mahashankham Bhimakarma Vrukodaraha. The meaning of the shloka is, Rishikesha blew the Panchajanya and Arjuna blew the Devadattam, and the wolf-bellied doer of terrible deeds Bhima blew the great conch Paundra. Rishikesha means lord of senses, and Panchajanyam is the name of his conch. It is said that when Krishna blew his conch, it caused fear in the hearts of his opponents. Devadattam is Arjuna's conch and was presented to him by Lord Indra. In this verse, Arjuna is addressed as Dhananjaya, which means Lord of Wealth, because Arjuna had won many wars and amassed a lot of wealth thereby. Bhima is addressed as Vrukodara. Vruka means wolf and Udara means stomach, means wolf bellied. It is seen that wolves are always hungry and eat a lot, but their waist is always slim. Bhima is a Vrukodara as he is known for his insatiable hunger and slim waist. The word Bhimakarma means achiever of unbelievable feats. Bhima alone is believed to have killed 6 out of 11 Kaurava Akshaunis. Bhima's charioteer was none other than Krishna's son. The Kauravas were afraid to face Bhima and were believed to send ahead elephants to fight with him. He said to have broken Drona's chariot 8 times and he killed an elephant by name Ashwatthama, which led to the killing of Dronacharya, who eventually gave up his weapons. Bhima alone killed all the 100 Kaurava brothers. He refrained from killing elders except Bahlika, because Bahlika himself asked Bhima to kill him and release him from the sin of fighting for the Kauravas. I'll be sharing many more interesting details about ancient wars in further episodes. Thank you for watching. Meet you soon.